Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Here in Israel, united in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
Unto the house of Israel.
So the Most High God has made these brothers up here with the purple shirt and fringes watchmen unto the house of Israel, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and the Native Americans.
Therefore, hear the word in my mouth.
So hear the word out of God's mouth. Where is God's mouth? This holy Bible.
That's right.
This Bible is God's mouth.
That's right.
And give them warning.
You know what?
Give them warning.
We out here to give you warning.
Bring it out.
We out here to give you warning because Christ going to destroy this planet.
Yes, bring it out.
He's going to destroy America with thermonuclear destruction.
Bring it out.
When them bombs drop, what you going to do? You going to go to your Christian pastor? You going to get burned up too.
Bring it out.
When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die. And thou givest him no warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked ways, to save his life. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity.
So if you don't repent and come back to the laws in this Bible, you're gonna die. According to the Bible. So I'm gonna give you a couple laws that our people in violation of today. Give me 1 Timothy 2:9, bro. 1 Timothy 2:9. We're gonna give you some of these laws.
That's right.
The Most High God told our women to dress with modest apparel.
That's right.
And we see a lot of women out here that dressing immodest.
Bring it out.
The book of 1 Timothy, chapter 2, verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
The Bible says a woman both adorn themselves in modest apparel. Not with short shorts on and tight, showing what you got.
Bring it out.
The only person that's supposed to see what you got is your husband, black woman.
That's right.
It's time to put your clothes back on. Put your long skirts back on. Put your long dresses back on.
Bring it up.
It's time to repent and keep the laws of God. And you mothers out here need to teach these laws to your children. Give me Deuteronomy 6:7.
Bring it out, huh? Bring it out.
We're teaching the laws of God to our children. Our children look up to Yo Gotti. Our children look up to, Barack Obama.
Bring it up.
They want to be Barack Obama, but ain't nobody talking about God's law.
Bring it out.
You're going to get put to death if you don't repent and come back to the laws of God.
Bring it out.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 7.
Read.
And thou shalt teach them diligently.
You should teach these laws of God diligently. Read.
Until thy children.
To who?
Until thy children.
Is anybody out here teaching their children the laws of God? Are you teaching your kids the laws of God? See, it's crickets. It's time for our people to repent. I'm going to give you another law of God. Give me Leviticus 11:7.
Bring it on.
Today is the Lord's seventh day, but our people done forgot about the Most High God's seventh day.
That's right.
Y'all
bring
out here, y'all out here barbecuing, cooking on the Lord's seventh day. It's a commandment not to cook on the Lord's seventh day.
Bring it on.
Y'all out here cooking up pig ass and swine on the Lord's seventh day. It's a commandment not to eat pork.
Bring it out.
These are your laws. These are not the other people's laws.
Right.
Read that out.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 11, verse 7.
Read.
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
The swine is a filthy, nasty pig that y'all probably had bacon bits this morning.
Bring it out.
Y'all done had bacon bits, bacon sausages, plates this morning.
Bring it out, huh?
It's time to repent from that thing.
Read. That's right.
So, he divides a hook.
So, he divides the hook, read.
And be cloven footed.
Read.
Yet, he chose not for cut.
Read.
He is unclean to you.
The Bible said the pig is unclean to you so-called blacks out here in Orange Mountain.
Bring it up.
Put the pig down. It's judgment for eating that. Give me Isaiah 66:17.
Bring it out!
The big down, Christ is gonna kill you, according to the scripture.
That's right.
Watch this.
Isaiah 66:17. It's judgment for eating unclean food. Put the crab leg down, put the swine down, and repent.
Bring it out.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 66, verse 17.
Read.
They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree in the midst, eating swine's flesh, and the abomination and the mouth shall be consumed together.
You see that? You're going to be destroyed. So it's time for our people to repent and come back to the laws of God and teach our people, teach our sisters how to dress. Give me Leviticus 19:29. It's time for our people to repent and come back to the laws of God. See, all young women don't go to dress like this. That is against God. Read that, huh?
The book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 29. Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore.
So if you're saying it's okay for your daughter to twerk, you prostitute your daughter.
Bring it out.
You're teaching them against God's law.
That's
I shouldn't be able to come out here and see young women's butts. I don't want to do that right there. I want our sisters to grow up in God's law. Give me Deuteronomy 22:5, bro. Y'all ain't gonna hear this in your Christian church. Y'all say that's good right there. Y'all say a little girl twerking at the parade is good.
That's right.
You say that's good. Read that out.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22, verse 5.
Read.
The woman should not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
The Bible says a woman shouldn't even wear what pertains to a man. But all women out here got on pants. Pants pertain to men.
Bring it
out. You got a zipper on front of your pants. What are you unzipping?
Bring
what
it
are you unzipping and flipping?
That's
time
right.
For our people to repent. Our people love their oppressor. Your slave master taught you that was good right there. Your slave master taught that was good right there. Give me Isaiah 5:20. I'll tell you what, give me Jeremiah 4:22, bro.
Bring it out. 4:22.
It's time for our people to hear this Bible as it both been taught. Y'all think twerking at the parade is good. That is not good. That's against God. Read that out.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 4, verse 22.
Read out.
For my people is foolish.
Read out,
Bible say his people is foolish.
Have not known me.
You don't know the God of this Bible.
Bring it out,
you don't know the God of this Bible. If you knew the God of this Bible, your daughters wouldn't be out here twerking. Here in Babylon the Great. It's time for our people to repent and come back to the law. Yeah, give me that, huh? Time for our people to come back to the laws of God. Who out here know their nationality? Who out here know how to get the kingdom? Who out here know how to get the kingdom of heaven? Working on the Lord's Sabbath, they ain't gonna get you the kingdom.
Right. Read it out.
Read.
Proverbs chapter 21, verse 16.
Read.
The man that wanders out of the way of understanding.
You people out here in this game have wandered out of the way of understanding. Your understanding, read.
Shall remain in the congregation of the dead.
Our people need to wake up. You're in the congregation of the dead. You're running out of the way of your understanding. And give me Deuteronomy 4 and 5. What's your understanding? What is your understanding? I got you, brother. How you doing? It's time for me to repent. You got a question, brother?
Yeah. I'm trying to figure out, man. My wife's sitting right here, and y'all just kind of
thank you.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. You teaching respect, right?
Yeah, we out here teaching the laws of God, bro.
Okay.
But see, bro, we out here to
teach. We teach right here, bro.
Give me Leviticus 19:17.
Bring it out,
bro. Nah, bro, you don't care about the Bible, bro. We out here because we love you. We telling you repent and keep the laws of God. You don't love this Bible, you don't love God, bro. Read that.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17.
Read.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thine heart.
And we come out here and have our daughters out here twerking. That means we hate our people.
Bring it out.
That means we hate you. We coming out here with the word of God because we love our people.
Bring it out.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
We out here to correct our neighbor. And you got to move down the street because the word of God, that's what you need to do.
That's right.
Bring it out. We love our people. We bringing the word of God out to our people. It's time to repent.
Hey, you talking about the whole
hour. And not suffer sin upon him.
We out here to not suffer sin on you because when you're breaking the Lord's Sabbath day, that is sin.
That's right.
When you're breaking God's Sabbath day, that is sin.
Bring it on.
All the people out here at this parade are in sin. Right. Only brothers out here that are not in sin is us because we're keeping the laws of God.
Damn. Right.
Read that.
The book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse 8.
Read.
Remember the Sabbath day.
God said, remember the Lord's Sabbath day, brother. Remember the Lord's Sabbath day. You forgot the Lord's Sabbath day because your daughter's out here twerking. Read. To keep it holy. You're about to keep the Sabbath day holy. You're about to keep the Sabbath day holy. Out here partying at a parade ain't keeping the Sabbath day holy.
Right, right.
I'm here to speak against that thing.
Hands up.
That's all right. I'm going to show you another way to keep the Lord's Sabbath day holy. Give me Exodus 35 and 3.
Bring it on.
The Exodus 35 and 3 telling you how to keep the Lord's Sabbath day holy. You're supposed to be out here to be thankful for the Most High God because he didn't put you to death.
That's right.
Time to repent. We don't care how old you are. If you're old and you're breaking God's law, that's same.
That's right.
It's time to repent. Read.
The book of Exodus, chapter 35, verse 3.
Read.
Ye shall kindle no fire throughout your habitations upon the Sabbath day.
God said, don't kindle no fire. Don't be out here cooking a big ass at the parade. Y'all got your barbecue grills out here. You say that's good. You say that's good cooking up ribs. You say ribs good on the Lord's Sabbath day. You say swine is good. Oh, bro, I got shrimp on the grill. You say that's good. Our people wicked as hell. Give me Isaiah 5 and 20. Y'all think this good? You got the slave master hair in your head. It's time to repent.
Read it out.
If you got blonde hair in your head, you need to repent from that thing.
Read it out.
Your hair don't grow like that, black woman. Read.
Read it out. Isaiah chapter 5, verse 20.
Read.
Go unto them that call evil good.
The Bible say destruction to the man that call evil good. Destruction won't mean destruction.
That's right.
And good evil.
You call good evil. You call cooking on the Lord's day, on the Sabbath day, good. Cooking up swine, prostituting your daughter.
Bring it up.
You say that's good. You want to teach your kid the laws of God.
Yeah, right.
Preach.
That put darkness for light.
Y'all put darkness for light. Y'all say your God is good. Y'all say Hillary Clinton is good. Y'all say T.D. Jakes is good. Y'all say Cleft Low Dollar is good. Oh, I'm going to listen to the word. You don't know what the word is.
Read
you don't know what the word. Give me Isaiah 8 and 20.
Read out.
You don't know. You ain't hearing no word in your churches.
Right.
We got the word right here.
Right.
We got the word. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 8, verse 20.
Read.
To the law and to the testimony.
To what?
To the law and to the testimony.
Read.
If they speak not according to this word.
According to this word?
To this word.
That's the word right there, the law and testimony of this Bible.
That's right.
Read on.
It is because there is no light in them.
Ain't no light in you if you ain't coming to this Bible.
Oh,
if you ain't keeping the laws of God, ain't no light to you. Give me Proverbs 6:23.
Bring it out!
You, if you ain't keeping the laws of God, it's time for our people to repent.
That's right!
For too long, y'all been following your slave master cousin. Your slave master started this parade. This parade ain't a God. Y'all forgot about the laws of God. What about the Day of Atonement? What about the Feast of Tabernacles? Y'all ain't heard about that God because you don't know the God of this Bible.
Bring it out!
The book of Proverbs, chapter 6, verse 23.
Read.
But the commandment is a lamp, and the law is light.
The commandment is light, and the law is light. It's time for our people to repent and come back to the laws of God. Give me 1 John 2:3. Y'all don't know God out here, because if you know God, you will keep his commandment. Where the Christians at? Where the Christians at to come up here and show us how to love God? Come up here and show us with your Bible how to love God. We're going to show you how to know God. Read that out.
The book of 1 John, chapter 2, verse 3.
Read.
And hereby we do know that we know him.
Y'all looking at us funny, but the brothers up here in this purple shirt with friends know how to know God.
That's right.
We know God. You don't know God. You think coming out to the game, that's good. Y'all talking about the Southern Heritage Classic. That ain't your heritage. Your heritage is in this fight.
And hereby we do know that we know him if we keep his commandments.
So that's how you know God, if you're keeping the commandments of God. Our people cast aside the words of God to have fun at the game. Give me Zechariah. Zechariah 7:11, bruh.
Bring it on up! Bring it out!
You cast aside the laws of God, but you keep your slave master custom. The people that brought you over here chained to the bottom of a ship. You say that's good.
Bring it out!
You love your slave master, but you hate your God.
Read. The book of Zechariah, chapter 7, verse 11.
Read.
But they refused to hearken.
But they refused. Read.
And pulled away their shoulders. And stopped their ears.
You stop your ears when this Bible coming out. When the laws of God is coming out, you stop your ears. And our men out here, they might well be twerking doing that stepping in the game.
Bring it out!
That's an effeminate look right there. Deuteronomy 23:17. You need to stop all that marching, bro. That look effeminate right there. Our men need to be men.
Read out.
Stop all that old gay marching right there. Read that.
Read the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23:17. There shall be no horn of the daughters of Israel.
Read that again. That should be what?
There shall be no horn of the daughters of Israel, nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
It's time for our people to repent. Y'all love that right there. Y'all need to be hollering for this Bible.
Yeah. That's right.
Y'all love the man. Yeah, read it up. It's time for our people to repent. Some promise right here. It's time for our people to repent. Ain't that any good right here?
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night.
The Bible say the day of the Lord gonna come as a thief in the night.
That's right.
Y'all out here listen to the sonic boom. Christ gonna bring the real boom on you, Negro.
Bring it out.
In the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise.
That's gonna be the sound of the boom right there. Boom.
Bring it out.
And there's gonna be a lot of y'all can put to death because you hate the laws of God.
That's right.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
The Most High said it's going to be some fervent heat. Fervent heat. Now give me that in Zechariah. Now we talk about the real sonic boom. We ain't talking about this fake sonic boom, but y'all out here laughing. And y'all laughing on the Lord's day.
Yeah.
God said, turn around your pleasure on his day.
Yeah.
We out here to cast that down right now. We're against this thing. Read.
The book of Zechariah, chapter 14, verse 12.
Read.
And this shall be the plague, the plague, wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem.
Have you fighting against this Bible? The Most High God gonna smite you with a plague.
That's right.
Listen, what this plague gonna do, read?
Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet.
Y'all gonna be right here at the game when the real sonic boom come through.
Read it.
Right here at the parade when the real sonic boom came through.
That's right.
Read?
And their eyes shall consume away in their holes.
Your eyes gonna melt in your holes. It's time to repent. It's time to repent. Our people don't fear the Lord. Our people do not fear God. Read.
And their tongue shall consume away in their mouth.
Your tongue gonna get consumed away in your mouth. That's the real sonic boom right
there.
That's the real sonic boom. Time about me to repent. Stop calling evil good and keep the laws of God.
That's right.
We're against all this crap right here. Give me Jeremiah 1 and 10. Give me Jeremiah 1 and 10. The Most High God sent us out here to cast down this stuff.
That's right.
We are here to cast down all these false lies and dreams out here.
Bring it up.
Time to repent and come back to the laws of God.
That's right.
And our women need to put on some clothes. We're sick of this.
That's right.
Put on clothes. Y'all say being naked is good.
Bring it out,
man. Tights is good.
Bring it up.
Showing all your stuff. We don't want to see that thing.
Bring it out.
All of y'all got big pits in your leg. We don't want to see that thing.
Tell me. Read
the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, verse 10.
Read.
See, I have set this day. See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down.
We are here to root out. We are here to root out all these lies. We are here to root out all these lies and all this stuff that y'all say is good.
That's right.
We want to root that thing out. Y'all forgot y'all God. You forgot your God, and now you serving the white man.
That's your God.
You serving Caesar, boys here.
Right.
He told you it was okay to break the laws of God.
Right.
He told you it was okay, but you ain't serving the God of Israel, the one that put them chains on your neck.
You ain't serving
the God that put y'all through Jim Crow laws.
That's right.
What about that God?
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone, 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.